So I'm here to introduce you to Hydrusha project. My name is Eleni Nyktari. I'm a researcher in National Technical University of Athens. So a bit of info of Hydrusha. This is a Horizon 2020 research and innovation project funded by the EU. The full title is Demonstration of Water Loops with Innovative Regenerative Business Models for the Mediterranean Region. It was funded by under the call water in the context of circular economy. It's a 4.5-year project. It's quite big. Now we are in the middle, a bit later. And Hydrusha is materialized through 13 innovation in 6 demo sites. We named them Hydro 1 to Hydro 6 in 3 Greek islands, Lesbos, Tinos, and Mykonos. 28 partners from 10 countries are collaborating on the project, and NTUA is the coordinator. So I invite you to watch the video.
Future summer day on an island. One of the hottest summers this island has ever seen. But wait, there is an oasis ahead. How is this possible? Let's see where it all started back in 2018 with Hydrusha, an innovation action project funded by the European Union with the ambition to create regenerative and nature-based water solutions. We are a constellation of international partners consisting of universities, research institutions, companies, NGOs, water utilities, and municipalities, and we are on a mission. Let's think for a moment. The Mediterranean region faces significant challenges. Dry zones, places with high touristic activity during the summer, problematic farming practices, wasted water resources. In Hydrusha, we revolutionize the water value chain by closing the loops. And the revolution is circular. We use a combination of techniques, both traditional, like local crops and natural irrigation systems, and modern, like ICT technology and online monitoring, mixed with biomimicry technologies, nature-inspired innovations. The journey of Hydrusha has already started in 3 Mediterranean islands. Let's take a look at how they work. On the island of Lesbos, we develop a rich agroforestry ecosystem. We treat domestic sewage by anaerobic processes coupled with constructed wetlands to produce biogas, which is upgraded to methane and used to fuel a car, sludge to be processed through an innovative compost cultivator, and treated water, free from pathogens, that will directly be used to fertigate and irrigate a 10,000 square meter field, including forestry trees, orchards, bushes, and herbs. On Mykonos Island, we install an innovative rainwater harvesting system on a remote dry hill to irrigate oregano and produce essential oils from it. Meanwhile, on the same island, we collect rainwater from the house's rooftops to provide water for domestic use such as toilet flushing and to recharge groundwater sources for the irrigation of a lavender field. Moving now to Tinos Island, we apply an innovative and nature-based desalination system that mimics the mangrove plants to produce edible salt and to irrigate a tropical fruit greenhouse. On a different site of the island, we upgrade an existing ecotourism facility with a combination of applications. The system aims to create self-sufficiency in terms of water, energy, and food production. All our systems are circular, creating holistic regenerative solutions that can be customized and integrated to local needs. This is our journey for now, but 26 more islands and coastal areas are about to follow, from France and Egypt to Mexico and Australia. We are a community of water allies. We are closing water circles and we come with solutions. Join the circle.
That was it. So the goal, this is Hydrusha in one picture shown in the video. So as Fabio noted, the goal in the circular economy approach is to abandon the take, make, dispose culture and recover recover and use resources and products. So the overall concept of the project is organized around the recovery and harvesting of non-conventional water sources as wastewater, rainwater, seawater, vapor in water scarce area. The reclaimed sources are injected to the local economy, and this can stimulate the economic growth, especially in agricultural sector. So our goals are first to demonstrate the feasibility of these innovative nature-based solutions in order to recover and preserve water materials and energy from different types of water, to decrease water acquisition cost, to integrate within the supply chain the citizens and the farmers, and to promote novel agricultural practices and precision irrigation within the water, food and energy nexus. So, stepping now into the solution, starting up with Lesbos Island. Here, low-cost reclaimed water is produced, combining anaerobic processes, upflow anaerobic sludge blanket and wasp, and constructing wetlands for the treatment of the domestic wastewater of Andisa village. After disinfection, the natural rich water is used for fertigation of an agroforestry system, which is Hydro 2. So here we can see the flow diagram of Hydro 1. The biogas produced from the UASB is upgraded to methane and used as fuel for local vehicles. The sludge is going through the composting unit mixed with green biomass and then used in the cultivation of Hydro 2. The UASB effluent is going through the subsurface vertical flow wetlands, saturated and unsaturated. And then after the ultrafiltration and UV treatment is used as irrigation water. So the solution here is a self-sustaining wastewater management system where water, nutrients and the produced sludge are reused. So now focusing a bit on the constructing wetlands that the IRIDRA team designed. You can see now the top view of the whole Hydro 1 system, and you can see at the bottom some of the modes. In total, the design allows us to test up to 6 different configurations, usually recirculation or not, and by bassam chamber. So we can investigate the best scheme for the Greek and other Mediterranean conditions. So for example, during winter, we need the best effluent quality as we do not irrigate and we discard it in the nearby river. But during irrigation periods, we need the nitrogen for fertigation. As in Greece, for example, the limit for fertigation for nitrogen is 45 milligrams per liter. But also we have to consider different applications in countries with different legislation. So the point here was to, and this was the conclusion, to make a really flexible system with a wide application potential. Here you can see some photos of the construction phase and the final installation of the constructing wetlands on the top. And there's also the pilot unit that I didn't refer to. We have some pilot constructed wetlands and a bioelectrified wetland that is just going to treat 1 cubic meter of the total influent. And at the bottom, we have the UASB reactors, the biogas upgrade and the collectors. So the reclaimed water, which contains high nutrient content, and the compost is used in Hydro 2, which is a non-nectar agroforestry system. This system was selected as a different approach on cultivation that increases diversity, productivity and profitability. The selected plants for the agroforestry include trees, shrubs, aromatic plants and annual crops. These were selected after intensive research of Hydrosa team, but were also co-created with locals that share their experience and knowledge on appropriate plants. So here we have 10,000 cubic meters per year of water reused in agriculture to irrigate the 1 hectare of crops, trees, etc. We have no fertilizer import, and we create resilient species. Going on in Mykonos Island, where the cost of water or even the non-availability of water in some cases are putting a severe pressure on agricultural growth, we implement a rainwater harvesting system. So especially Hydro 3, located in Anomera village in Mykonos, is a shallow subsurface rainwater collector of 280 square meters. This is a demo of it. And it's designed to collect rainwater by draining and transport it into two storage tanks of total 60 cubic meters water storage, and eventually to irrigate 0.4 hectares of oregano cultivation. The final product of it will be high added value essential oils. It's worth mentioning that the rainwater collection uses zero energy, which is really important. So going on with the other demo site in Mykonos Island, this is Hydro 4. Again, here we collect mainly rainwater, but for different use. The main use is for domestic needs. It consists of three subsystems. The first collect rainwater from rooftops and use it for the needs of the households. Then we can treat with the second sump system, which is a slow sump filtration system. We can treat part of this water that we collected in order to produce drinking water quality. And then we have subsystem three, where again rainwater is collected, but from the surface runoffs and used for irrigation. The excess water in this case is used to recharge the aquifer. And then the second source is the storm water. Here we use a basal system, which is an open drainage system that collects and partially treats the storm water. Again, this is used for the irrigation of lavender cultivation, and essential oil is also the final added value product in this case. Going on in Tinos Island, we have first Hydro 4 demo site. Here we have a natural inspired low cost desalination system based on the principle of evaporation and condensation. Located in Agios Phokas Tinos, in Tinos, the mangrove still system is inspired by mangrove plant, and this treats seawater and brine from the existing desalination plant in the island in order to produce fresh water and salt. The fresh water is used for irrigation of tropical fruits in the production greenhouse that is next to it. And fresh water is also produced in the pilot saltwater evaporation greenhouse, where atmospheric moisture is generated and converted into fresh water by means of condensation. Here, mangroves and aliphates are planted in order to enhance this process. Technology, the MSS, developed by Planet, has attracted the attention of the community, as it was reported by the CNBS documentary, and also won recently a grant by Middle East Desalination Research Center of Oman in order to develop further technology. Going on with Hydro 6, which is implemented within Tinos Eco Lodge. This is an ecotouristic facility in Stenni, Tinos. This aims to demonstrate how a small touristic unit can be self-sufficient and sustainable, applying efficient management cycle of water, energy and food. So you can see here the water loops of Eco Lodge. This includes the segregation of wastewater, treating the grey water in reed beds and then using the reclaimed water after UV for irrigation and for toilet flushing. Rainwater is also collected from the roofs of the lodges and the greenhouse in order to irrigate edible plants. And also when needed, stream water is used. Also within this loop, we have added the vapor condensation, which is implemented using a pilot innovative system in order to produce drinking water quality. All functions apart through PV system of energy production and storage. Apart from the design, the construction and the operation of hydro demo sites within the project, we carry out, of course, the evaluation of the technical, the environmental and the social sustainability of the solution or services. So we came up with a decentralized management model where we recover resources for the local community without intermediaries. So we produce locally to consume locally, and this is very important. And supporting also the farm to fork policy of the Green Deal. Making this cycle possible, we reduce also the payback periods of the system, making it even more appealing for the locals. An important goal of Hydrusa is also the replication of the business models that are developed within the project in other areas. As mentioned in the video, we have 26 early adopter sites around the world. Business models are elaborating for these cases, considering for each case the barriers and covering the full water, energy, food and service chain. Especially these days, we are dealing with Gorgona Island in Italy, where the consultation has already started. And there we're going to establish funding options and support the full development of the site, designing, implementation, operation, and the commercial exploitation of the secondary services. So now we step into Hydrusa's most important phase, as almost all of the project solutions are already developed and are operational. We have 2 years ahead to show how circularity can be the solution to water scarcity, supporting at the same time the sustainable agricultural development and biodiversity. So this was for me. Thank you all.